Dear students, we all know that the atoms combine to form the molecules, and they do so to have the noble gas electronic configuration, that is the octet in their valence shell. The atoms can combine with the atoms of the same elements, or they can also combine with the atoms of the different elements. When they combine, the bond is formed. The bond is majorly of two types, ionic bond and the covalent bond. Ionic bond is formed by the transfer of electrons, and covalent bond is formed by the sharing of electrons. These molecules also have some or the other shape. Sidgwick and Powell suggested valence shell electron pair repulsion theory to explain the shape of the different molecules. This is also known as, in short, VSEPR theory. Today we will study about valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. First of all, let us study about the assumptions. The shape of the molecule depends upon the number of the valence shell electron pairs. Electron pairs can be bonded or non-bonded around the central atom. That is, the shape of a molecule depends upon the number of the electron pairs. These electron pairs can be bonded or non-bonded. Let me explain you with the help of this example. In the case of ammonia, the bond between the N and H is known as the bonded pair. But you can see an electron pair over this nitrogen. This electron pair, which is not participating in any type of bond formation, is known as the lone pair. Now, the total number of these electron pairs will decide the shape of the molecules, which we will study by taking different examples. The pairs of the electrons in the valence shell, they repel one another since their electron clouds are negatively charged. That is, there is a repulsion between all these electron pairs. These pairs of electrons tend to occupy such positions in the space that minimize repulsions and thus maximize distance between them. The tendency is to enter into the most stable position, that is, the minimum repulsion and thus the maximum distances. Now, there are three types of repulsions, and the repulsive interactions decreases in the order: lone pair lone pair repulsions, lone pair bond pair repulsions, and bond pair repulsions. Now, from here we can see that the lone pair repulsions are strongest or greater than the lone pair and bond pair repulsion, which in turn is greater than bond pair repulsion. Repulsions between the electron pairs results in the deviations from the idealized shapes and alterations in the bond angle. Again, we will see the distortions in the idealized shapes and the alterations in the bond examples. Molecules can be divided into two categories: molecules in which the central atom has no lone pair, and the second category is the molecules in which the central atom has one or more lone pairs. The central atom which has no lone pair will be having the ideal shape. But all those molecules in which the lone pairs are present, then there will be definitely lone pair repulsion or lone pair bond pair repulsion. And due to these repulsions, there will be distortions in the shape and there will be a change in the bond angle. Now, I am explaining you the VSEPR theory via various examples. First of all, the simplest example, the shape of a molecule containing two electron pair, and the shape will be linear. There will be two regions of electron density, and the maximum distance the two regions of the electron density can get away from affords a geometry called linear. Now, this is the beryllium chloride molecule. The black ball is beryllium and the green balls are the two chlorine atoms. Now we can see that this is the covalent bond and there are two electron densities. Just to have the minimum repulsion, now they take the shape of a linear molecule and the angle between these two chlorine atoms is 180 degrees. This is a linear molecule and there is only one possibility. This is the shape you can see, the linear shape. Now, the next example, for molecules containing three or more atoms, one of the atom is called the central atom to which other atoms are linked. Now, the next example, three regions of electron density. The maximum distance three regions of electron density can get away from affords a geometry called trigonal planar. This is an example of a planar trigonal molecule, BF3. This black atom is the boron and these three green are the fluorine atoms. Now, all are bonded pairs, you can very well see, and to have the minimum repulsion, they take the shape of a planar trigonal. If in the second case, if there is a lone pair and there are only two bonded pairs, in total we can see that there are three electron pairs, out of which two are bonded pairs but one is a lone pair, which is shown by this blue dumbbell. Now, you can see this is an example of SO2, sulfur dioxide, and there will be a bit distortion and the angle will be reduced from 120 degrees to 119 degrees. In this ideal shape, the angle was 120 degrees, but in this molecule, due to lone pair bond pair repulsion, now the angle is reduced from 120 degrees to 119 degrees. This is a sulfur dioxide molecule. Now, the next case, when there are four regions of electron density, the maximum distance the four regions of electron density can get away from affords a geometry called tetrahedral. And again in tetrahedral, there are three possible shapes of the molecules whose geometry is tetrahedral. Now, you can see this. This is an ideal tetrahedral. This is a molecule of methane, CH4. This black dot is carbon and these are four hydrogens. Now, you can see this. This is a tetrahedral shape. And the angle here is 109.5 degrees. Now, the second possibility in the tetrahedral case is that out of four electron pairs, there are three bonded pairs, but there is one lone pair shown by the blue dumbbell. Now, due to this lone pair of electron, there will be bond pair lone pair repulsion. This is ammonia molecule. In ammonia molecule NH3, the blue light blue dot is the light blue atom is nitrogen and these white atoms are hydrogen. And on this atom of nitrogen, there is a lone pair of electron. Now, there will be a repulsion and when there is a repulsion, there is the distortion in the space. And the molecule is distorted from the regular tetrahedron. Now, the angle from this 109.5 degrees is reduced to 107 degrees in ammonia molecule. The second situation is when there are two lone pairs. Out of four molecules, there are two bonded pairs and two lone pairs. Now, there are two types of repulsions here again, the lone pair repulsion and lone pair bond pair repulsion. Due to these repulsions, the tetrahedral shape is further distorted and the angle is reduced to 104 degrees and the shape is known as bent shape. This is regular tetrahedron, angle 109.5 degrees. This is pyramidal shape, that is ammonia, angle is reduced to 107 degrees. And this is water, it is bent shape and the angle is reduced to 104 degrees. You can see the values of the bond angles, how they are reduced from 109.5 degrees to 107 and 104.5 degrees in water. Now, the next case is the 5 regions of electron density. The maximum distance 5 regions of electron density can get away from affords a geometry called trigonal bipyramidal. Now, this is an ideal trigonal bipyramidal. Example is phosphorus pentachloride. This black atom is phosphorus and these red atoms are chlorine. Now, you can see this, the 3 chlorine atoms are in one plane and the 2 chlorine atoms are one above the plane and the other below this plane. The angle between these chlorine atoms is 120 degrees and the angle between these chlorine atoms is 90 degrees. So, in all, in the trigonal bipyramidal shape, 3 angles are of 120 degrees and the 2 angles are of 90 degrees. These bonds are known as equatorial bonds and these bonds are known as axial bonds. This is ideal trigonal bipyramidal shape. Now, the further possibilities in this shapes are. The first case, this is a molecule of SF4. Here you can see that there are 4 bonded pairs, but there is one lone pair. It has occupied the equatorial position. This is known as seesaw shaped and there is a distortion. It is not known as trigonal pyramidal, but it is known as seesaw shape. Now, let me show you why seesaw shape. It resembles a seesaw. This is SF4. Now, again the distortion when there are 2 lone pair of electrons. Now, these 2 lone pair of electrons has taken the equatorial position. Now, you can see the shape of the molecule. This is T-shaped. This is T-shaped and there are lone pair repulsions and lone pair bond pair repulsions. The example of this type of molecule is ClF3. The third type of distortion, when there are 3 lone pair of electrons, they all have occupied the equatorial position. The example is xenon difluoride. Now, you can see this black dot is xenon and these 2 are fluorine atoms. It has taken the linear shape and all those equatorial positions are occupied by the lone pair. So, we can see that the distorted shapes in the trigonal bipyramidal shape. Now, you can see from the slide also. 6 regions of electron density. The maximum distance 6 regions of electron density can get away from affords a geometry called octahedral. There are 5 possible shapes of the molecules whose geometry is octahedral. In the first instance, all the regions are the bonding regions and the shape of the molecule is the same as the geometry around the central atom octahedral SF6. Now, this is SF6. Here you can see the octahedral shape. This black atom is sulfur and these blue atoms are fluorine. Now, you can see the regular octahedral molecule. All these angles are 90 degrees. Now, again in this shape, the distortions are possible when there are lone pairs. Now, let me show you the first possible distortion. Here, out of 6 position, 1 position is occupied by this lone pair and when the lone pair is there, there is the lone pair bond pair repulsion. This is an example of IF5. The black atom is iodine and the green atoms are fluorine. This shape is known as square pyramidal. The next possible distortion is when there are 2 lone pair of electrons. This is the example of XEF4. This is a square planar shape. you can see the two blue lobes which are lone pair of electrons, and this is known as square planar. You can see the distortions in the regular octahedral shape. The octahedral, square pyramidal and square planar. These were the major ideal shapes: linear, trigonal planar, tetrahedral, trigonal bipyramidal and octahedral. These are all ideal shapes, and whenever there is a lone pair, these ideal shapes are distorted and the bond angles are also distorted. This is the summary of valence shell electron pair model. You can see the possibilities: the linear one, the trigonal, there are two possibilities. In tetrahedral, there are three possibilities: no lone pair, then one lone pair, and the two lone pairs in the tetrahedral geometry. This is trigonal bipyramidal, and the total four possibilities. First case, the PCL5, when all are bonded pairs. SF4, when there is one lone pair and four bonded pairs. CLF3, when there are two lone pairs and three bonded pairs. XCF2, when there are three lone pairs and two bond pairs. This is octahedral shape, when all the six bonds are bonded pair, this is SF6. The next case is BRF5 or IF5, we can say, when there is one lone pair and five bonded pairs. This is a square pyramidal. Then XCF4, that is square planar, when there are four bonded pairs and two lone pairs. So, dear students, I hope and I am sure the valence shell electron pair repulsion theory is very much clear to you. You must have understood the shapes of the various molecules, the role of the bonded pair of electron and the role of the lone pair of electrons. It is very much clear to you that how these lone pair of electrons are distorting the idealized shapes. Thank you.